It all happened so quickly. I remember I only sent her a message in May, and I invited her to go on a road trip with me. And she bought the tickets within 2 weeks. And we have come into a conclusion that this trip has to be chill by the ocean. I remember I told her, I like how spontaneous it is. And she said, we all need a spontaneous friend. The older I am, the more I realize that your friend is not always around with you 24/7. Not to mention, minds always scatter all around the world. We're all busy and go through our own shits, and we may not be for each other all the time. So I always treasure the moment I can share with them. Well, our relationship is kind of funny. I've known her for around 2 or 3 years during university. We aren't particularly close. In fact, I think I've only hung out with her for 3 times. And no one knows we're a friend, actually. So, not to be cheesy, but we kind of know each other, that we're a similar type of person, like we share the same vibe. We are all an introvert, very emotional, and ocean is our soulmate. This trip is quite new for both of us, road trip, and our first girl trip since we graduated from high school, and our first surf town. We drove around Eland in Taiwan and stayed in a very nice, chill surf town. We're basically living by the ocean, and it's something we've always been dreaming of, and it's just the best thing. I would say Eland is a very down-to-earth city. It's definitely not a tourist attraction, but the city has so much connection with nature. One day, we woke up at 5 a.m. to chase the sunrise. We're simply staring at the sky for straight 45 minutes. We patiently waited for the sun to come up, and we were just so amazed by how beautiful the nature could be. Went to a hot spring park. We drove at least 90 minutes to go up to the mountain. And during that trip, we did a lot of carpool songs. We discussed why this is our favorite song and how the lyrics speak to us. And we looped all the early 2000 songs and just sing in the car. When we arrived at the hot spring park, we dipped our feet into the hot water that are generated from the earth's surface, and we just quietly sitting down there, looking at the mountains, feeling the breeze from the rain, listening to the sound of water dripping. I guess we just need a therapy for our body and soul. It's also so funny that we can actually cook with the water. And we cooked some eggs and some corns, and we just sat under a tent and enjoyed our meal. And just admiring the beautiful scenery around us. Speaking of food, we had a lot of food and a lot of late night meals. One thing that I'm so happy about during this trip is we supported a lot of local businesses. Eland is not an international city, Therefore, we did have the chance to try out many authentic food. There are a lot of cute local cafes where we can just sit and daydreaming. It's the best thing ever. Having a cup of coffee or tea, and then we just sat there. We didn't speak anything, and just having the time and the space for us to daydream. Having our meal silently is also our love language. I guess we're just genuinely happy for our stomach. We both love eating so much. It revives our inner child. One night, we went to a night market and we bought a lot of food, and we just sat in the car and finished all those food with less than 15 minutes. And it's like, it's our inner child. We're super happy. Silence has also taken a major part in our trip. It's the main reason why I have to do voiceover in this video, because when I go through all these clips and footage, we're just busy at enjoying the moments, relaxing, and didn't bother to speak at all. I call it comfortable silence, which is very important to me. It's the moment that I don't need to bother to think to what to say to each other, and I don't need to feel obligated to start a conversation. It's simply just the two of us acknowledge the fact that we need this moment of peace and calmness. We share a routine every single night. When we back to our hotel, we lay down on the sofa. We weren't talking to each other for at least 30 minutes. During that period of time, we usually look at all those silly photos that we took during the day, and thinking about all those good food that we ate, and planning what should we eat tomorrow, and where should we go and explore tomorrow. It's just we're spending the time to rewinding how fun, how tired, how relaxed the day was, and it gradually become our routine every single day.
Just you and me. know you think we're moving too soon. I love to hear you when you complain about your best friend, how she's so late. And as you're talking, I'll start thinking, all the details start sinking. But I don't care about the right now. Spend the summer in this beach house. Conspiracies on TV.